the name to remember.
New legal questions this morning about Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump and their access to the president and security measures. Sources tell CNN that one of Ivanka Trump's business deals is now under investigation just days after her husband's security clearance was downgraded. Joining me now, CNN national security analyst, former FBI special agent Asha Rangappa, and CNN contributor and former director of the Office of Government Ethics, Walter Schaub. Asha, I want to start with you. So the FBI is investigating one of Ivanka Trump's business deals. This is from Vancouver in February of 2017. Is this standard operating procedure?
Well, John, we need to make clear that a counterintelligence investigation is not the same as a criminal investigation. So This doesn't necessarily mean that Ivanka has broken any laws or done anything wrong. However, what it does mean is that there is some foreign intelligence nexus between this business deal and what they see as an opportunity. We don't know what country this is, but remember that in places like Russia, banks, businessmen are not necessarily independent of Putin or the security state. So when someone like Ivanka has access, as she does being in the White House, and a potential vulnerability, a financial need, a foreign intelligence service may see this as an opportunity to exploit. And this is something that the FBI would look into, because we don't want that anywhere near the White House, because it can be a national security risk.
So, Walter, when it comes to Ivanka Trump and Jared Kushner, you say, and I'm going to read this, nepotism is the gift that keeps on giving if you like gifts of disaster. Explain.
Well, look, this is the foreseeable type of harm you get with nepotism. When the president chose to bring his daughter and his son-in-law into the White House and depart from the tradition of all modern presidents, in fact, depart from the practice under a nepotism law that has stood for half a century, he decided to take on a different kind of level of risk. For one thing, it motivated him and the rest of the White House not to hold them to the same standards they normally hold assistance to the president to with regard to divesting financial conflicts of interest. It is true that both Jared Kushner and Ivanka Trump divested a good number of assets, but they also kept a number of significant holdings that you would not normally expect to see a White House appointee hold. And the nature of those holdings is such that they're inevitably entangled with foreign interests, because these are large real estate projects in the case of Jared Kushner, or licensing and trademark issues involving Ivanka Trump. And so they are by nature exposed to lots of opportunities for exactly the type of thing Asha just talked about, that it creates a risk that they are out there doing business with these types of individuals. I don't see how it could be anything but inevitable that some foreign power would try to exploit that to leverage them or influence them.
Asha, one other bit of news we got overnight has to do with Andy McCabe, the former deputy director of the FBI. There's this Justice Department Inspector General review going on, and both the Washington Post and the New York Times are reporting that Andy McCabe is going to be faulted for improper media disclosures. Now, that's essentially leaking in some form or fashion, but it doesn't have to do with Donald Trump, which is what the president often said. It has to do with the Clinton campaign and the Clinton Foundation. Still, is this something that will give the FBI a headache?
It will. Look, the FBI needs to be nonpartisan and not seen as political one way or the other. So whenever you have a senior official who appears, even there's a perception that they are trying to express or influence or do anything with their political views outside the scope of their private lives, which they're entitled to do, that does have an impact on the FBI generally. This does debunk this allegation that the FBI has been this pro-Hillary Clinton cabal, but I do think that it continues this perception that the FBI is political, and that is not something that it needs right now.
Walter, if I can go back to Ivanka Trump for a moment, one of the things she said in an NBC interview with Peter Alexander was that she hasn't been contacted by the special counsel. Look, I'm not suggesting that Ivanka Trump did or did not do anything wrong, but she was a key player in the campaign. She is a key player in the White House, and many key players have now testified before the special counsel. Is it odd to you that she hasn't?
Well, not necessarily. The nature of any criminal investigation is you're going to start from the outer fringes and work your way in. So she may not be off the hook forever. In addition, you know, it's not a monolithic entity. The campaign, the transition team, or the White House had different people doing different things. It's entirely possible she may not have been involved in some of the types of things that Mueller's looking at.
All right, Walter Schaub, Asha Rangappa, thanks so much for being with us this morning. I appreciate it.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Wall Street set to open just moments from now, this after the president's announcement.